Hello, I'm David Lawrence, the Chief Academic Officer and Principal of the Dayton Regional STEM School. And the Dayton Regional STEM School is now in its third year of operation. I'm here because I think that systematically the education system in the United States has to be changed. There are many countries who are doing things in different ways that are more effective than we are here. And I think the STEM school is a shining light to the rest of the country who's educating children in how we can develop critical thinkers. So this is, for me, almost a calling that we have a national emergency called education, and I'm here to assist in whatever way I can in helping contribute to fixing that national emergency. This is a special place with special people here who are assisting me in this process of developing students. And I can't think of any other place that I'd rather be at this time. This school is really unique because of its high caliber of instruction, interdisciplinary focus, integrated units, inquiry-based projects. These are all fancy teacher or pedagogical terms for teachers really care here. They work really hard to make this an enjoyable, engaging experience for students daily. And those are terms that are bandied about a lot in education, and it doesn't always work like people say it does, but it certainly does here.
My name is Kate Cook. I grew up in the Northeast and really discovered a love for the natural world and a curiosity in the natural world, which led me to my undergraduate degree, which was actually a double degree in music and in neuroscience. And I had a real interest in how people's brains understand and how we learn. I always wanted to be a teacher. It's because I want to make a difference in the world. The college that I went to had a slogan that said, think one person can change the world, so do we. And that is my mission as a teacher, is I truly believe that teaching is the best way I know how to impact people, to help make a difference in the world, and to help make the world a better place. I think in science, it's especially important that students build upon a natural curiosity of the world. If we look at any child who is outside, playing in the yard, looking at a butterfly, people are interested, kids are interested. And unfortunately, I think sometimes kids lose that curiosity. As a science educator, I think we need to build upon that curiosity. And I think inquiry-based learning helps us to do that. Inquiry-based learning is centered around a driving question. So the driving question could be, what makes cells cancerous? And we use that to drive the unit. So we present that question in a way in which students see it as a phenomena. Here's this thing that happens, and let's figure out why it happens. So what makes cells cancerous? And then throughout the unit, students explore the different possibilities of what could make cells cancerous. This type of learning, the inquiry-based, project-based learning, in which students are trying to solve real-world issues, the students have to be engaged in what they're learning. They love what they're learning. They want to come up with solutions. I have never once in my class been asked, why do we have to learn this? Because they know exactly why we have to learn it, because we have to make a difference. So we really try to work with our partners and pull in different experts in different areas and people that can add to the learning that students are doing. We use partners in a way that the partners are collaborating with the students. The partners aren't just telling students, this is how it is. The students are asking the partners questions, the partners are asking the students questions, and they are building upon the knowledge set together.
The school is a regional cooperative where we bring students from all over the region. We also collaborate with partners throughout the region as well. The Air Force Research Lab, Materials and Manufacturing, Propulsion and Sensors, Wright State University, Sinclair College, Central State University, University of Dayton, all of the local colleges in the area are partners with us with developing curriculum, summer activities, after-school enrichment, and expertise and support in content areas that we definitely have here, but they serve as a tremendous support. One of the things that really kind of makes me light up is the power lunch, where the partners or our partners who work at various places come in, and they explain to students over lunch what they actually do and how they do it, and how they kind of got to where they are. So you're able to see, so to speak, people who are actually working in the industry. You don't just read about it, you don't just talk about it, but they're here to tell you the reality of what they do every day so that you can determine if that's going to be your best career choice.
My name is Eric Copeland, and I'm a junior here at the Dayton Regional STEM School. I came here because I felt that it was going to be a good opportunity for me, because if I'm good at math and I feel that I can be strong in it, I might as well get challenged while I'm doing it. So that's why I came here. It's good because I'm doing something that I'm not used to, so I'm getting a change.
I'm Maddie Nagel. I'm an 11th grader at the Dayton Regional STEM School. I'm really excited to be a part of the first graduating class because the whole region is really excited about it. And it's something really exciting that I don't think a lot of other high school students get to experience, is this entire community is just really, really like waiting for our graduation. I chose to come to the Dayton Regional STEM School because when I was in about the 8th grade, my mom was in an education class with one of the science teachers. And she was explaining this amazing opportunity and the fact that the entire region and all of like the really big businesses were involved in it. And it was really exciting and really different. And I was already a little bit bored. And I knew that this was going to be a really big challenge. And it was really, it has been.
One of the qualities that the school teaches is persistence, and you have to be persistent if you want to do something in life. So you got to be persistent about it and keep doing it and keep doing it until you reach that goal, and then when you reach that goal, build higher on it. Like if I have a business or if I am a sports player or in sports medicine, I want to be able to own my own thing, to be able to call it my own and say that, you know, I had to help a people to do this, and now it's as big as it is. You know, if I have to start out small, but I couldn't just quit if it's not working out, I would have to keep going and going and going until I got to the point where I wanted to be, and then build on top of that. With the same thing with sports, I might not be as good as it right now, but if I keep practicing and I keep working at it and be persistent, I'll be able to be where I want to be.
I feel like everyone, they find out you're at the STEM school, and people just, there's so much energy and they're really excited about it. I feel like every time we turn around, there's a business person or a, you know, college coming in doing videos, and it's really, really helpful and useful because you see how everything you're learning is a career that someone has out in the Dayton region.
It's a team effort every day with all of us focused on the same goal. And that goal is to develop students' critical thinking skills, problem-based solving skills, and develop those students as the next generation of STEM employees in the region. There is a focus on STEM jobs. They're there to be had. We just need to be a hub to develop those students. So the story kind of goes like this. We develop you. You enter, hopefully, an area university. Wright State University would be the one I would choose. And after you leave Wright State University's colleges of mathematics, arts and sciences, and engineering, with a graduate degree, you then reintegrate yourself into the area's STEM fields, which are abound.
STEM education at the Dayton Regional STEM School, I think, prepares students for the workforce in incredible ways. Students learn to think critically, they learn to analyze, they become deeply interested in the STEM fields, and I think this helps to fill the positions that we're looking to fill in the STEM fields, and it helps to fill the positions with critical thinkers and people who question the world and want to make the world a better place.
I want to thank Wright State for all the work that they've done to make our school so amazing, and I want to thank all of our partners for their continued support, and we hope to see you around.